talk about how AI will develop and how it comes so for them 5 to 10 years. Technology is advancing faster, and it's taking us widely less to adopt than ever before. Like as in it took roughly 10,000 years to go from writing to printing press, but only 500 more to get to emails. But, I mean, like, now it seems we're at the dawn of a new age, the age of AI, artificial intelligence. Will a robot take my job is one of the most Googled questions, and it kind of makes sense. You know, when phones were first invented, there was probably horse messengers freaking out all over the joint. Vinyl's making a comeback. But fidelity aside, why bother when you can have a curated playlist with thousands of songs right on your phone? Change makes people panic, but things evolve regardless, so we accept it, we move on. And now that we're entering the so-called fourth industrial revolution, yeah, automation's gonna replace some jobs, but it will also create new ones, and probably give rise to industries that never existed before. Has anyone in this room heard of ChatGPT 4.0? I mean, I heard, y'all heard it. Oh, so let me introduce you, if you haven't heard of it. So basically, unlike the previous OpenAI models, this model uses real-time voice, image, and text data, interacting so naturally that it's easy to forget it's not a real person. This marks a significant step in human and computer interaction. Extending even further, human, computer, and animal interaction. In a demo, a man showed his dog to a woman over the phone, and GPT-4o reacted with excitement, demonstrating its ability to perceive and interact naturally. Unlike previous models, this model communicates not just through text, but also through voice and vision. And that makes it more emotional and human-like. This may be the latest and yet the best AI model that has the most potential in the future. And what this AI can do really creeps me out. But is it that big of a problem? I mean, AI is everywhere now. Even in the video that you're watching right now. I mean, not you guys, but the viewers. If they want to watch this video with subtitles on, YouTube's AI system will give them an option to choose which subtitle they want based on just reading my lips and hearing my words. That was just a small and a spontaneous example. But, like, let's go to our schools. As a student, wouldn't that be cool if each student has its own AI-driven personalized learning platforms, allowing each student to learn at their own pace and in their own style? Just imagine a classroom where each student has a customized learning path, making education more effective and enjoyable. I believe that in the future, us humans and machines can coexist harmoniously. If you ask me, there's no need to fear artificial intelligence. Because for me, artificial intelligence is not so much artificial as it is an alternative form of intelligence. At least that's how I see it. It approaches the things within our capacity from a different angle, from a different perspective. See, 100 years ago, life expectancy was only 45. Can you believe that? Then by the 1950s, it was up to 65. And now it's almost 80. Tomorrow, who knows, right? Healthcare has developed so much. We have eradicated epidemics that used to kill millions. But life is fragile. People still get sick or pass away for diseases that maybe should be something curable. What if we could improve diagnosis? Innovate to predict illness instead of just react to it. In the next 5 to 10 years, artificial intelligence could revolutionize healthcare. AI could predict diseases before symptoms appear, give us personalized treatment plans, and continuously monitor our health through wearable devices. In the future, we can have so much potential. Healthcare will become more proactive, more accessible, and more personalized than ever before. At least that's all I have to say. Thank you all for listening.